And we're back.
Screen. All right, we're good.
Glad you're a failure in every way.
I try. Hey, some cool breeze is actually flowing in. I might not die of heatstroke tonight.
Hey!
And my favorite enemies right away.
And gear.
I should really actually use his auto crossbow.
Yes, if you are going to melee attack him, go ahead and throw the mithril pike you got from Mog on him.
That's a good idea.
Because he uses pikes, typically.
I like how he has just, like, a World War I fucking gas mask going on.
Final Fantasy VI is in a weird place technology-wise.
Oh, well.
Oh, he already had a mithril blade. Probably throw that on, yeah.
And anything for you? Nope, you're good.
She got a mithril knife.
That's fine. Okay, so we were going for a cave last time, I remember.
Yes, we need to go south from here.
Let's go steal. Couldn't steal. Alright. Yeah, south from here, because that's more or less where it dropped us off at last time.
Yeah. South from here and...
Yep, there it is.
Yep. Directly south from here.
Man, I just realized how much of this game is in Final Fantasy VII, because like I'm just realizing that they pretty much have the world map at the same angle, and they have the exact same mini-map for the world right there. Same style, too.
Huh. That's pretty cool.
More or less. Nope. I'm sure. Alright, we're good. Hey.
You got your cave license.
Yes, it's right here. My spelunking license.
I see. Well then, King Edgar, I think you should be on. Wait a minute. You got your king license. He's on to us.
He's on to us. Stab him.
The battle screen.
Turtle.
Turtle.
I love you, Turtle.
Turtle. If that's just a healing spring, so we don't have to go all the way back to town.
Huzzah. My eyeball is itchy. Ouchie.
Just take your spoon and just kind of dig in there until it doesn't itch anymore. You'll know it doesn't itch because there's a searing red pain.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, no.
It's a noise blaster. Let's do it.
Stab him with your sound waves. I think what the noise blaster does is it confuses them temporarily for like a turn. So you
Sounds
can just
good.
Smack. After you hit them, they just turn back around. Heat burn.
What was that animation?
Did it just summon a stand?
I don't know. Once again, giving us gangbusters GP.
Yeah.
Tincture.
I think those are effectively useless.
Well, let's,
Or at least the one that cures blind.
Oh. Those should be eye drops. Yeah, these are 50 MP.
Oh, never mind. I'm fucking entirely wrong. It's been a while since I played this game. I don't use a lot of items either, typically, in Final Fantasy games. I'm a hoarder, I'll admit it.
Looks good. Oh, bastards. God, those look like those fat-ass Hercules beetle grubs.
Yeah.
These things get, like, the size of, like, twice your hand or some shit.
I mean, it makes sense. Hercules beetles are pretty fucking big.
Yeah.
They're also cool.
Really cool.
And Japanese kids make them wrestle. That's how we got Pokemon.
Okay. You look suspicious. No, you're not.
It's probably my only complaint with Final Fantasy VI is that there's an unnecessary amount of stuff just obfuscated by the map terrain.
Does you guys have anything? Remedies. Good.
A literal level is useful. I wouldn't go out of my way for him.
Eat hot lead.
Pop a cap in their ass. I'm trying to remember who you get next. I think it's a...
Okay, calm down with the encounter end in here, Satan.
No. What's that? Literally every square?
I'm starting to suspect.
There's a map, or not a map, a hallway in the original Final Fantasy in the one of the caves that's involved with getting to the Earth Crystal.
Yeah.
And in that hallway alone, literally every step is an encounter, and it's an encounter that specifically only appears in that spot.
Sick.
Well, like the enemies show up in other places, but those particular enemy combinations don't show up anywhere else in that cave.
I believe that.
And it's really useful for early game grinding.
Oh, we made it. Cool.
We did it.
I think there was an unexplored path passage to like the right or something like that, but I think we can survive.
I'm sure it wasn't.
Grease monk.
Grease monk. They're just dudes with wrenches. Just dudes.
Get some of the old bioblaster.
And I'm with the gas.
Right now, like, I think Edgar's just objectively the most powerful dude in the party right now.
Yes, he does kind of get outshined later, especially when you get Gao in 7.
I believe it.
But in this early stage, he's incredibly powerful. Hey!
Hey, I see him.
Look at that character right there.
Yeah, I know, right? I'm going to follow him. And he's gone.
In this cafe. Was he ever even there to begin with? Also, look at that, just a prostitute sitting across from him.
Hey! Bam!
He owes allegiance to no one. He'll do anything for money. Sasuke.
You know.
Oh!
Alright.
Don't do it.
Yeah, that's how you spell that word.
He'd slit his mom's throat for a nickel.
Well, what if I want to pay him for his services? The dogs eat. All right. What about you? What do you gotta say? Riveting.
Hey, that's information for later. Are kids allowed in here? What do you think? Alright.
Yeah, alright. Well, I don't see anything wrong with this picture if you don't.
I ain't gonna tell nobody if you don't.
I thought this was like a turnip.
Yeah, it kinda does look like one. Big old flowery turnip.
Yeah, why not?
It's steep, but we're here.
Dude, we got cash.
I know there are a few inns that are objectively just don't ever go to them, like the one in the Empire. Okay. No, don't sleep with that inn. You should be alright for now, though. Tora.
I want to be the anime girl.
Anime.
Is there a run button?
No.
Okay.
There explicitly isn't, because there's a relic you can buy, I think about now, actually, called, or you can find them somewhere. that are the running shoes. And as long as you have them on literally anyone in the party, you will move at a faster speed.
That's cool. Alright. What's in here?
Which, speaking of, we should look to get some relics on our butt.
That sounds good. What are you doing?
A baby?
Yeah, probably. Oh.
And, check that barrel. Okay.
Ah!
Because this one kind of follows Pokemon rules, where sometimes there's just hidden items.
Okay.
I checked the clock. Excuse me.
Okay, hold on. Missing all the... Oh, that's not the button. I will humor you with the clock. Yeah. What about that bookshelf?
Maybe? I think that was the only one that was in here, though.
Yeah, alright. We did our due diligence.
Now the barrel in the front. One of them has something on them.
Phoenix Town, yeah. Trevor knows what Trevor talks about.
He knows.
Perhaps too much.
Trevor knows much. Tell some.
Eh? Who? What? Fancy draft, you say?
Yeah. Ha-ha. This is an important location to remember for later.
Okay. I am engraving it into my mind. This looks like a piss bucket and a chair.
Ominous. And a save point.
Alright, let's rotate those saves. Wait, did that actually save? Oh. I think it's because, because Terra's a lower level. Okay.
Yeah, it's going off for a little while right now.
Okay.
Now, I know there's goodies in here.
That looks like a chest. Yeah.
Some kind of chest box.
No clock, it's ticking. Yeah.
1,000
GP, hell yeah.
Oh, you can't get both.
Wow.
Andy. Dick move.
It's not taking.
Ominous.
What could possibly be happening here?
I'm sure some evil sorcery that we'll never be privy to. I think there's another secret hidden passage on the wall on our side. The wall closest to us that's obfuscated by the terrain.
Ah. Like right here or something?
Yeah, on that wall, but I'm not sure. Go back via towards where you were before.
Alright.
Go parallel with the hallway.
Ah.
Ah! I was right.
Ah, there we go. Stairs. Alright. Hyper Wrist.
That's actually really useful. If I remember what that is. I think it's something for Edgar. You have to go under the relics.
Ah.
They have their own separate equip menu. It's stupid, but whatever. Raises Vigor. Yes, that is something you want on him. Okay. I don't think we have any other relics right now.
Alright, sounds good.
I do know there's a relic.
Hey!
Dude, hey! Baby!
We were talking about you.
Probably throw him on lock.
Alright. Sounds good.
Because Terra can get some pretty good stuff that makes her magic do the hurt. Whereas most of the stuff that Locke can get, we're not going to get for a little while. I don't think it matters who's in front. I just know someone has to have it. Wait. Check the description on those. Maybe I have him confused with another item.
Okay, is this how we're gonna do this?
Remove him, yeah. Oh. Well, that's still something you want on him, but I'm thinking of something else. That's still good, because that means he's gonna be a lot faster in combat.
Yeah.
Which is what he...
Well, that was a pretty good side detour over there.
Mm-hmm.
Because we got, like, 2,500 and two relics.
Not bad. And they're pretty substantial relics, that both very useful.
Sounds
good. Like, on my personal playthrough, I had the Hyper Wrist on Edgar for quite a while until you get the Atlas Armlet, which is the same thing, but better in literally every way.
Sounds good. Alright. What you got?
The Regal Cutlass. You're going to want that for Terra.
That's a good idea. We don't want 11 of them.
Sure. And I think that's really it's all that's useful here.
Yep. What about you? Identical man across the hallway.
That's my brother, Doc.
No, we're not doing this.
He's closer to the docks. That's why they call him Doc. And I'm closer to the back of the city, so they call me Shu.
We don't want them 11, goddammit.
Yeah, you are going to want three of them, though, because they are pretty good. Your band?
It's my one for Edgar.
Yeah. You're going to want to save most of your money, because, again, like, we're going to have access to relics, and some of them are fairly expensive.
I believe it.
We can come back and get the good shit later.
Alright, that's good. Now let's get the hizzle out of here.
The hisnizzle. Also, realizing kind of at this point, you have the basically the first three members of the original Final Fantasy cast. You got the fighter, the thief, and the white. I guess not the white mage. She's close to being a black mage.
Actually, she's kind of almost a red mage because she has attack and heal magic.
Well, on a literal level.
Yeah.
But that's because Final Fantasy VI does not have classes. Pretty much every character is the character they're going to be forever.
Yep. I think this is probably going to be the last time that we see classes again until 12? I think, I want to say. I could be wrong. Because 7 didn't have classes. 8 doesn't have classes, to my knowledge. I played very little 8, but from what I saw, no real classes.
Not
I don't think 9 did.
10 doesn't.
10 doesn't. Is 10 the MMO or is 11 the MMO?
11 is the MMO.
No, I'm retarded. 10. 10 is fucking Titus 11. Yeah, so no classes there. They have the sphere grid, though, but that's something entirely different.
That's a different hell.
11's the MMO, and 12 is fucking Ivalice and all that shit.
Right.
I remember.
Now, fortunately, as far as magic goes, this one is probably the least complicated. You can put magic on literally anyone. Some characters aren't worth having it, but you can have it on literally anyone. It just takes grinding.
I can grind. And we're going to need these, because I'm a clumsy fuck.
Yeah, you say you got to Celis, so you didn't... You haven't encountered Magicite really yet.
Okay. At what point do you get Celis? Because I do remember meeting Rama.
Okay, so you get Celis before Rama.
Okay, then I've gotten to Rama and I've gotten Magicite, and okay. I ground a couple of spells on some people, and then that was about it.
Yeah. Okay. So, by then, Terra's AF. Or not AFK, I guess, but she's out of commission.
Yeah, she was gone at that point.
And you have Celis, or not Celis, worse Celis, Terra. You have Terra up until then. You have up until, like, the battle at the ice village there.
Yeah.
So, yeah, she's, I don't know what I'm trying to say anymore. I'm just blithering. So Celis is actually pretty early compared to that.
Okay.
More or less, we're going to recruit Sabin up ahead.
Yeah, I know he's pretty early, all things considered. I remember us fighting his, like, rival or some shit.
Yes. Yeah, they actually were talking about him from that one guy. He was talking about, oh, Duncan and his shitty-ass student. This is where you can just rent a chocobo. We don't need to do that right now.
Right. Is there a cutscene we have to trigger here before we can leave?
No.
Hold on. We are in Figaro, right? South Figaro?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't remember there being one, because we come back here.
Sable Mountain Range. All right.
Our next mission is to go to that mountain range, because we're trying to go find the returner base.
Right.
And, the Mount Colt is between us and there. So we're gonna go do that. Celis will reluctantly be like, okay, I guess I'll be your secret nuke instead of their secret nuke. And that starts the chain of events that causes, the party to split.
Right.
And then we add the large bulk of our cast during that section, like Gao and Gao Cyan, who is definitively one of the worst characters. Don't use Cyan if you don't have to, because again, I may have said this before, but Final Fantasy VI's characters are defined by their abilities. And Bushido, or whatever they call it in the American version,
yeah,
it poo poo. It is bad.
Sounds great.
Mostly because this is a time-based game, and to get some of his better abilities, you have to wait longer physical amounts of time in combat. So you're just getting wailed on while you're building up to an attack that does less damage than just, like, the Firestorm combo on Saturn.
Right.
So it's just really not worth it.
Alright. Makes sense.
You get Cyan, you're gonna get Gao, you'll meet up with Shadow briefly on a couple of occasions.
Yeah.
Terra, Edgar, and no. Yeah, it was Terran Edgar along with Dude Face who go up the river.
Yeah, I remember the river.
And then Sabin gets sent alone. He meets up with Cyan and Gao.
Yeah.
So he kind of marches off on his own. And then Locke goes off on his own where he meets up with Celis.
Right.
Okay.
That looks like another cave right there, but I'm going to go down here.
I'm piecing the pieces back together.
Ah, okay, that's nothing down there. Because
right. This game is rather huge, and even I can't admit to having beaten it. I have gotten to the second half.
Right.
Which is the big part, and that's the part where...
Yeah, I do know something about a World of Ruin or something like that.
Yes.
I know the vague whisperings of it, but I've never gotten to that section. I think Anthony's gotten to that section before.
So in more or less turns, I'm not going to undergo, like, what actually happens.
Right.
You have the World of Balance, which is what we're in right now.
Yeah.
And pretty much you have access to everything up to that point, once you have the airship.
Yeah. I remember the Opera House.
The Opera House is a fun second.
Who's that mysterious figure?
So Act 1 is basically gather all of your main cast minus one or two extras.
Right.
Like all you have all of your characters you're pretty much going to be running with by the end of the first second.
Right.
The first Act 2 is basically everyone is scattered to the winds, and you gotta go find them again.
Right.
And because of that, that I say that Celis, if there is a main character of Final Fantasy VI, it's Celis.
Right.
Because Celis is the only character you're required to beat the game with.
Right.
You don't have to bring anyone else. So if you were a madman and wanted to kill yourself, I guess, you could go up to the final boss with just Celis at level 99. That's actually an exploit, too. Because when in that section, if you recruit one of your party members back, they are recruited at the level of you, of Celis.
Mm.
So, what you can do is, if you have a lot of time and patience, you can get Celis to level 99. And then pick everyone else up, and they'll all be at level 99.
Baller.
For this kind of playthrough, I really wouldn't recommend it.
Yeah, no. Like, I'm probably just going to play it like a normal goddamn RPG.
But absolutely an option if you're lazy or crazy, or both.
I like how the lazy option is also the crazy option for once.
Yeah. I'm a fan of efforts of procrastination and laziness that require more effort.
Yeah, I think the only RPG that I've ever taken the time to get everybody up to their maximum level is Earthbound, and that's about it.
Yeah.
And in that, it's specifically because, A, the endgame area is really good for grinding, and there's only four people that I have to care about, so.
Yeah. Well, if you did want to go into the final boss in this game, you only bring four party members.
Right.
So, the four strongest people, which is probably going to be your choice of Terra and Celis, Sabin, Gao, and, I don't know, Locke. It's like, Sabin and Gao are your heavy hitters.
I believe it.
They do the big hurt. Then you have your caster. Actually, I think maybe even the other caster you get later on that I know you haven't met yet.
Right.
I think she might even be a better magic nuke than Celis or Terra, but I don't remember.
We'll hash it out when we get there.